Today we celebrate one of my favorite saints, Saint John of the Cross. Born Juan de Yepes in Spain, his father passed away shortly after he was born. And so he and his siblings and his single mother did what they could to get by. He worked as a painter, as a carpenter, he worked as a nurse for a while, and he joined seminary when he was 21. And while he was there, he got to meet Teresa of Avila, Saint Teresa of Avila. And she told him about this reform that she was doing in their order. He was really intrigued by this. And so he decided to do something similar in the male version of the Carmelite order, as Teresa of Avila was in the female version, obviously. He was in the male version of the Carmelite order. So he started this reform of the Carmelite order. But remember, we're sort of living in the time of the Inquisition. So any sort of reform or change to what's been done was seen with suspicion, including by his own brothers, who then imprisoned him. They kidnapped him, brought him to a castle where he was for 8 months. And he was not even given a change of clothes. He was just given bread and water to survive on. And while he was in this castle, in this closet in this castle, one day he heard someone singing love songs from the street. And he began to, in his head, write these poems in this sort of dark night of the soul, in this really challenging place in his faith life. When he was trying to do the best, but this is how he was treated, he heard this love song and he started to think about our relationship with God as a love between lovers, and this imagery of God the lover and us as the beloved. And so he started to write these poems in his mind in the midst of being horribly treated. One night, on a dark night, he was able to put together some fabric from a blanket and a tunic and scaled down this huge castle and ran away in order to escape. He ran to Teresa of Avila and her sisters and found refuge there and was sort of nursed right back to health. And he wrote down these poems that he had come to his mind as prayed with as he was in that place. And almost as quickly as he started writing poetry, he left it. And maybe what you know about him is this sort of dark night of the soul. What's interesting about the dark night of the soul as we know it is it's sort of used as a sense of God has totally abandoned me, that I don't feel anything from God. That is not at all what John of the Cross believed. In fact, his Dark Night of the Soul is based on the poem, The Dark Night of the Soul. What's really unique about John of the Cross is that his poems are sort of the basis of his spirituality. And then he writes these big books that are commentaries on these poems. Well, that's the case with Dark Night of the Soul. It's a poem, night. And instead of this sort of God has abandoned me, instead he believes that in those dark moments of life, that God is even more intensely with us. Sure, we might not experience God around us or feel his presence, but we know it in our heart. Our hearts are aflame with love. He loves that image of a heart inflamed. So I want to read you a couple verses about the first half of his poem, Night. Now, this is my own crude translation, so I kind of abandoned the worrying about the rhyming part, but instead want to give you the sense of what the words are. And these beautiful words now speak to us of what it is like when God is with us in those dark moments of life, but how we are filled with his love. Okay, here we go. On a dark night, with longings and love inflamed, O blessed fortune, I left without being noticed, my house already in deep repose. What he's talking about here is like being deep in prayer and contemplation, okay? As this house, right? Into the darkness and sure, by means of the secret disguised ladder, O blessed fortune, into the darkness and crazy in love, my house already in deep repose. On the fortunate night, in secret where no one saw, nor I saw anything, without any light and guide than that which burned in my heart, it guided me, more certain than the midday light, to where was waiting he who knows me well, in a place no one saw. O night, you guide me, O night more friendly than the dawn, O night that joined lover with beloved, beloved transformed in the lover. Now, love that last line, but it's even more gorgeous than the original Spanish. Here, let's give you a taste of it. O noche que juntaste, amado con amada, amada en el amado transformada. Lover, loved in the lover transformed. Now, doesn't sound like God's abandoning us there, right? So he's a great example for us of how God is with us in those difficult moments, how we are a set aflame with love for him. But if we wanted to sort of sum up the theology and the spirituality of John of the Cross, how would we do it? Well, he kind of does it for us. In one phrase that he liked to use, which was nada, 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 nothing, nothing, nothing. That when we go to pray, we don't have to worry about what to say, what to do, what to think, none of that. Just clear it out. Just think of nothing. Don't think of anything. Don't worry about anything. You don't even have to say anything. Don't worry about what's happening around you. Nothing, nothing, nothing. You're essentially clearing out space for God to work. We are essentially just putting ourselves at God's disposal with whatever God wants. God takes control of our prayer. So we might think about it a little bit like sunbathing. When we sunbathe, we don't really have to do anything. We don't have to worry about anything other than just being there and taking in the sun. Something similar is what John envisions for prayer and contemplation, that by our sort of disposing ourselves to the sun over and over and over again, we get a tan, right? We are drawn deeper into God's love. We learn to know more about him. But in this knowing, we learn that God is even greater than we can understand. So we put ourselves totally at God's beck and call, essentially. And he sums up, he gives this little beautiful summary of perfection, he calls it, in four verses. He has a little poem of four verses that he says sums up this whole spiritual life. So he says this: the whole of creation forgotten, its maker remembered forever. Inward, the gaze of the spirit, forever in love with the lover. So my challenge for you is to take some time today just to soak in the sun, to just be with Christ, to dispose yourself to God in prayer. Maybe just take 5 minutes, or even if that's too much, 2 minutes, just sitting there, just being with God. Sounds simple enough, but it is a challenge. But God gives us the grace to do it. God disposes us to this goodness when we dispose him of ourselves. So today we celebrate St. John. Take some time to contemplate God's love for you today. St. John of the Cross, pray for us.